thank you. Welcome. The first piece, if you don't have your phones out, was the Kyrie from one of Giovanni Gabrieli's Sacred Symphonies of 1597. I expect pretty much all of you are familiar to some extent with the Gabrielis, Giovanni in particular. Certainly for brass players, he forms kind of the fundament of our repertoire. And there are good reasons for that, one of them being that the music that he wrote, even the vocal music actually, just really lies well, I hope you agree, for modern brass instruments as much as the older ones. And there's a good reason for that, because really, Gabrieli was the first composer to write specifically for our instruments. Almost the first to write for specific instruments, period, although there was chamber music and solo instruments before that, but he was a real revolutionary. He kind of invented orchestration in a certain sense. He wrote specifically for the Cathedral of San Marco in Venice, where he was effectively the music director, court composer, and organist. And he had the inspiration that if he specified which instruments would go in which choirs in his polychoral writing, he could really exploit the effects that he was after. He kind of invented dynamics. So there were very, very few composers before him who wrote crescendos and diminuendos. He invented the notation of forte and piano. There's a sonata, Piano Forte, named that way for obvious reasons. So I think as beautiful as his music is, what's really important about Gabrieli was as a teacher and as a leader. He had many great students who, once his reputation grew around Europe, would come to Venice to study with him, and they would go back up north. And you can really trace the lineage of the way he orchestrated and the way he used details of notation all the way to Bach and beyond. So one more piece by Gabrieli, Angelus ad Pastores Alt.
Thank you. bass players, unfortunately. No. So the piece we'll be playing tonight, I wrote in the last 2 months. It's called Haywire. So Ryan Scott and NYO was gracious enough to ask for a new piece. And I was wondering what to do because we're playing Rain Tree, which is, you know, a staple work and very cool in Third Construction. And I thought the best thing to do would just be like have a little shred. So this piece is kind of about the terrifying but exciting break before NYO. This is, like, I just finished my undergrad at U of T, so that was insane, and then I had sort of made to ruminate and percolate and then get the Monster Chamber rep ready, which took a lot of time. So it's just about the process and the insanity. There's a lot of quotes for our repertoire that's coming later, so keep your ears open. And yeah, thank you very much to Ryan and to Chris and to NYO for making this happen. This has been really fun, and this is the best section could have ever asked for. It's just so much fun to play, so hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
So for the next piece, we're at the end of Act Two of Lohengrin. And Elsa, the heroine, is processing to the cathedral. Actually, I'll back up. Maybe you don't all know Lohengrin. It's a great opera. The next time you have 5 free hours, I highly recommend it. She is trying to beat a murder rap in Act One, and a literal knight in shining armor rides in on a swan to save the day. Fights the bad guy, wins her, and so she, you know, the good news is she doesn't have to go to jail. The bad news is he won't say his name, and she has to marry him, or everything goes up in smoke. It's a lovely opera. It's like all of Wagner's operas. The more you dig into the plot, the odder it gets. But it's full of beautiful music. This procession is, I think, just some of the most exquisite music that Wagner ever wrote. It's grand and poignant, and you can hear throughout, but especially at the very end, you can hear this little note of warning and of fear, you know, that it's everything is not exactly perfect. So this is Elsa's procession from Lohengrin.
Thank you.
next work is an arrangement of a choral piece, a Sanctus, by the Norwegian-American composer Ola Jalo. He writes almost exclusively for choral ensembles, a bit of piano music and so on, but he's a pretty young composer, really making a name for himself. This arrangement, which we think is a terrific arrangement, made by Taz Eddy, who's a wonderful trumpet player. I know some of my colleagues have played with him some, and he, of course, is an NYO alum, who was here about 10 years ago, 2011 to 13, I believe. So this is Sanctus by Ola Jalo.
Thank you.
Our final work is an arrangement of Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition. You all know, I'm sure, that there are many transcriptions, versions of this piece. Mussorgsky only wrote it for piano, but very quickly, orchestral composers saw so many possibilities in the colors that he suggested with his titles and that he wrote into the music. This particular arrangement is by Elgar Howarth, who is a wonderful trumpet player, composer, conductor, arranger in London. And a number of us have played this a number of times, and we really love it. It's a real showpiece for the entire brass ensemble, and really shows off the complete range, expressive range, and dynamic range of what brass instruments can do. So this is Pictures at an Exhibition, Mussorgsky/Howarth.
Thank you. Thank you.